How's it going, all you perfectly awesome people, and welcome back to OneShot. So, I'm back. Yep. I don't think anyone else is noticing it either. Am I the only one who's seeing this? So, last we left off, we first got into this new area, the new city, and what else did we do? We basically fixed an elevator, met some mechanic guy, and now we're here. I'm pretty sure this is gonna be the last episode, if I'm being completely honest. Beep boop. Beep boop. Oh, hey, person. Are you alright? The Messiah. Perhaps this is a sign. Tell me, do you think you can fix the world with the sun? Honestly, I don't know. I've been getting mixed messages. I know. But what do you think? I think I should listen to Dylan. After all, Dylan helped me get this far. I'll take your faith for an answer then. What do you mean by that? It means whatever you think it means. Yeah, no pressure there, thanks, Nico. Nah, no pressure at all. So I remember we did run this way and we found a shop, and I think there was like an alley or something too. Yeah, here's the alley. Oh god. Why does it always get, like, dark and scary? It's a trash bin. It's a trash bin. Oh, God. Dylan, do you see what happened? Yeah. My vision went blank for a second. Then I saw something. Like a really short dream. Wonder what that was about. That was really weird, and I don't know what that was. It kind of looked like a fox, but then it had a light on it. Also, I didn't read that. A bag full of trash. Gross. Trash bin. A trash bin. It's a trash bin. Bag full of trash. Gross. Alright, so I'm guessing that's all the same. It's a faded flyer. No, so you're not going to read it? But at least now we have music. It's a faded flyer. Still not going to read it. Same with this area. Last area had a lot of places. This one does too. What's this? Curious marking on the wall. It looks like a ram. Is this gonna be like a bird people hideout thing? Also, I'm very, like, I'm curious as, like, how the world... Oh, wait, hold on, what's this? It's strangely warm in this room. I'm curious, like, how... I don't know, like, what everyone is in this world. Because there are people. There are definitely, like, regular people, as we saw earlier. But then there's also, like, robots with, you know, consciousness and all that, which we saw in the very beginning. Then there's the bird people. And then there's, like, those people that have, like, items for heads. Anyway, what do you have to say? Oh, these are... I'm talking to the cat, not you. Oh, a cat. Are you lost? Me? Do you wish to join us? Join your cats? Yes. I'm not a cat. I don't walk on four legs like they do. You have cat eyes. My ears are normal people. Or, my eyes are normal people eyes. Well, normal back home. Your hat is shaped like a cat. I'm just a person. You are still welcome here. I protect lost people as well. Thanks. But I'm not lost, though. I've got Dylan to guide me. I see. Well, at least, you know. I don't know what I was gonna say. Alright, so let's check what's up here. Oh my god, it's such a big area. Like, actually, this might be the biggest area, because I don't know what else is farther to the... Can I... Please, do not approach. Oh, I want to help you. Alright, we'll go down here first. Ooh, more jars. A jar full of red glowing fluid. Another book! It's a big book. The title says, Understanding Robots. What's this? There's some big plastic discs in here. Looks like they're supposed to be in something. Wait, Dylan, are you really gonna take these with us? But they look so heavy. Alright. Oh gosh. Hey, they're actually pretty light. Oh. Okay, good. I was gonna say, I don't want you, you know, being a hunchback all over the place. A lantern plant. There's a note attached. It says, "Thank you for working hard, Mr. Lamplighter." Oh. Big books. These are dictionaries. Some of the words are underlined. Most of the words are underlined. Framed photo of someone. So is this the friend? Oh gosh, a lot of lenses. Concave lens, thin lens, convex lens, thick lens, empty tube. Still have the weird film, I still have the journal, I still have a feather, I still have an amber, and I still have the shirt. I'm not sure. Wait, all those, like, the feather wasn't optional, the amber wasn't optional. I bet there's going to be something like that I get in this area, too, because I've gotten the amber from the girl, I've gotten the feather from the kid, so I'm guessing I'm going to get something from the other guy, because he's one of the main characters of this area. And then I got the novelty shirt, which was an optional thing. I still have the weird film, even though I figured out that puzzle, so I'm not sure why I still have that. And then I still have the strange journal, but that I had to have gotten. I just haven't gotten any answers to what's in the strange journal, because Nico can't read it. Oh. Yeah, see, there's people like this that just have weird heads. Hey, kid. Want some soup dumplings? They're guaranteed to contain only a minimal amount of industrial byproducts. I'll pass. Good idea, Nico. What about you? It smells kind of nice. What's in it? Breaded fish. I toasted the bread myself. I see. See, and then there's regular people like this. Are you here for the photos? No. Alrighty then. I'll just, stand here. And then this person doesn't have a head, but still selling things. This stand smells a bit like burnt sugar. Yep, still getting the hang of making these fried candy skewers. They don't taste too bad, though. Do you want one? Oh, it's okay, thank you. So, like, what makes these people different from these people? You know what I'm saying? What's in here? It didn't do anything. There's a slot here. It looks like paper or something might come out from it. Is this a camera? Can I take my picture? Can I get a little picture of Nico? Actually, that'd be adorable. Wait, hold on. There's numbers on here. It's an empty rectangular slot. Looks like something could fit in here. Could I put convex lens? I can. I really hope it doesn't matter which way these go in. Oh, yeah. Because there's numbers on the top, so... Oh, God. It's a little right combination. Okay, so... I'm guessing I'm gonna have to figure out... combination to put those in, but I have no idea how to. What do you have? Hey, ready for me to blow your mind? Yeah. Okay, so... I've invented a machine to prepare everyone for the upcoming water shortage. All you gotta do is dissolve one of these pills in the water, and then you drink the water. And then you never need to drink water again. What? Oh, so makes plants grow faster. How does it work? Here, why don't you take a free sample? Oh, thanks? Don't thank me. Go spread the word. That seems, very far-fetched. Water pill. Goes in water, supposedly. Supposedly. It's down there. Alright, yeah, so this is a very big area. Is this the library? Nice music in here. Alright, just making sure there's... Oh wait, what's this? Alright. Just a big X. Nice and peaceful in here. Looks like I can... Wait, what'd you say? You can unlock the door? Okay. Is this back at the... It is! Oh. Oh, hey there. You have a lot of fish. Yeah, I'm worried about them. Oh? I heard something about how the square particle stuff just took out a major pipeline. Guess I should take advantage of the running water while I still can. And, like, normally I would have just said, oh, the people with the heads have an occupation, or the people with the weird heads have an occupation, like an actual stable job. But that one lady was selling things, And that was her job. And there was also the lady in the diner. So, I don't know. Evening news. Are you here to purchase a copy? No. Newspaper are for grown-ups. Grown-ups? Yeah. What does that mean? It means people who aren't kids. Kids? Or aren't you a kid? I am a robot. Alright. Oh, right. Yeah. I mean, you should still have a grasp for what grown-ups and kids are, but... God, this is a really big area. Hello, person. The library is up ahead. Thanks. Oh, okay, good. So this is the library. When the world ends, would it be better if it was gone in an instant or slowly fading away? To be honest, I'd rather the former. Yeah, I think I'd prefer an instantaneous one. One without pain or suffering. I kind of got deep for a second. I'm sorry. So nothing over here. Alright, well, let's go into the library. The author's book cover is a wide range of topics. It seems there are no subjects he does not write about. Quite the Renaissance man, don't you think? I guess so. But he's been focusing on documenting the world as of late. Oh? They say this city is the last bastion of civilization. The last bastion? Like Overwatch last bastion? Soon these books may be the only thing we have to remember the rest of the world by. Ah. Are you the librarian? What? Well, I didn't say anything. Well, stop staring at me then. I was just looking for your book. Yes, you are in a library. There's books in the library. Go bug the chatty one upstairs. Oh, hello. Do you need directions? Let's see. This area here is mostly historical accounts. The reference section is downstairs, and not sure where the children's section is. Sorry. That's okay. I'm not really looking for books. Oh, are you here to look for the author then? Nope. Oh, that's good. That means you won't be disappointed. I've been volunteering here for months, and I've never seen him, not even once. He works together with the head librarian on publishing, so you'd think he would at least show up once in a while. Is the author going to be the guy who writes the computers because I have one of his books, and the book was only able to be obtained if I got the information from the computer that opened the safe in which I found the book? But he doesn't. Yeah, he seems kind of reclusive, which is weird for a guy who supposedly travels the world. Maybe it's just around people. Computer, it's currently off. Boom, 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 boom. Yep, still scared of ladders. Hello, person. Hi. You're shelving in progress. Please watch out for potential falling books. I will. So it looks like this place didn't have a whole iRobot epidemic, which is good. Are you the librarian? The author is so cool. I heard he can travel all over the world with a flying machine. That's how he gathers materials for his books. Yeah, see, flying machine? That must be the friend from the other place. Wow. Anything over here? No. Yeah, like, what separates the people with object heads and people with normal heads? So what do you think about the author? I don't know. Have you read his stuff yet? If not, you should. Big book with a black clover on it, on the cover. Title says, Emergency of New Ecological Niches in a Post-Sun World. Phosphor shrimp, also known as seed shrimp in certain I'm not even going to try and say that. Due to the shape of their transparent coat, these aquatic invertebrates are the most abundant life form in the ocean surrounding the barrens. Common firefly, a nocturnal beetle with a vibrant glow, sometimes captured in mass and put in jars to use as living lamps by the Glen's residents. This has inspired the now commonplace practice of using phosphor shrimps to do the same. Okay, so phosphor shrimps were in the first area, which they used for light. The fireflies were in the second area. Oh, is that it? Huh. Okay, that was it. So, what do they use in this area? Big book with the black clover on the cover. The title says, a comprehensive guide to phosphor. It's a general rule, if a phosphor loses its glow entirely, it cannot be relit unless exposed to the sun. If the phosphor is merely dim, it may be possible to boost it through exposure to another phosphor of higher energy. But even so, the boosted phosphor will never return to its original brightness. Chapter 5, a survey of phosphors found in the natural world. Blue phosphor. Out of the common phosphors, blue phosphor is of moderate levels of energy. It can exist in both organic and mineral forms. The mineral form is most commonly found in metallic sand of the barrens. The organic form is most commonly found in the phosphor shrimp and their secretions. Although the light emission of blue phosphor is powerful, it is what I would describe as self-conserving properties. That is to say, the glow may not be consistent. Most forms of the blue phosphor will stop glowing if left undisturbed for long periods of time. If using blue phosphor to power machines, a motor should be set as a baseline level of activity to ensure constant ignition of the phosphor. Alternatively, live phosphor shrimp can be used. Green phosphor. Okay, I'm not going to read this. If you guys want to read it, you can just pause the video. Seems like there's different types of phosphor. Going through these pages pretty fast. Actually, it's mostly pictures. Oh, yeah, the author doesn't only write books, he also illustrates them. Sometimes he makes books out of only pictures. Neat. The author publishes books at a high, accelerated, almost inhuman pace. In fact, he has put out more books in 1 year than most authors do in a lifetime. According to the head librarian, there is still a large amount of material he has written, but not yet published. One cannot help but wonder where he can get so much done in so little time. I did the calculations, and the numbers simply do not add up. Maybe he can stop time. No such mechanism exists in this world. Is that actually possible in your home dimension? Nah, I just saw it in a movie once about superheroes and stuff. I mean, you never know. This is a completely different universe. The author's latest books are really something, yeah? The head librarian just released a bunch last week. Oh? They're big compendiums. You'll see them if you look around. Kind of different from his earlier works, though. I'm used to reading his travelogues and novels, mostly. I apologize again if, I'm just unable to pronounce words or speak fluently at times. It's like reading in, you know, middle school all over again, reading to the class. Are you the head librarian? What are you doing to that book? Don't worry, these are my own words that I wrote. I just pulled them off the shelves to modify them. I have to cross out some sections. Most sections. How come? Because otherwise they'll think I copied him. Him? The author. I mean, I really don't see the point of writing anything anymore. The author is just gonna write about the same thing and then everyone will love it. And nobody's gonna remember the books that came out before his. I ain't hating. I can see why people go nuts over his stuff. This guy has got major talent, but it just hurts, you know? It's never fun when people call you a copycat for something you wrote about first. I can see that. People call me a cat all the time. Even though I'm a person, cats are pets. And mousers. I sure hope people don't think I eat mice. Then I guess we're in the same boat, kiddo. Yeah, that's hard. You know, when you make something first and then everyone's like, oh, you're just a copycat. So I approach from the front. I'm sorry. I apologize. I meant to just talk to this guy. I'm on my third cup. I can't feel my limbs. But I have to stay awake. I need to find out how this book ends. Chris the author and his beautiful cliffhangers. Alright, what do you have to say? Excuse me. Oh, you are the Messiah. Welcome. When I first entered the city, a big robot told me to look for the library on the surface. This is the same library, right? Affirmative. Oh, goody. Well, we're here. What do we do now? The big robot only said there'd be clues here. That is a question for the head librarian, George. Allow me to call her. Don't mind me just doodling my fingers here. any day now? It's, okay. She's not picking up. Is she not here? She is here. She's in the archive room upstairs. When she is concentrating on her work, she will ignore any and all phone calls for several days. Yikes. Can you get her in person then? Leaving this post is not in my programming. Then can I go myself? Of course. The archive room is accessible through the stairway behind me. Gotcha. Thanks. Unauthorized entry. Library card required for further access. Wait, what? Library card required for further access. I don't have a library card, though. Where can I get one? This is a question for the head library. Okay, great. This is... Oh, my God. No, don't call her. Okay. Alright. Okay. Me and Nico, I feel the same way. Just leave, Nico. Just sprint. Make a run for it. She's not picking up. I figured. Are you sure I can't just... You can't just let me through? Let you through without a library card is against my programming. What? Even in an emergency? My programming is not flexible. I have not been tamed. Ah. Alright, well. On the road to a library card, I guess. How I get one? I don't know. There's still a lot of area to explore, so... Onward, young Nico. Oh, new area. A little bit creepy music, but new area nonetheless. Let's go, Nico. Oh god, it's like the library, but there's no one. Alright, well, I guess we'll go in then. Oh, it's a factory. Just like the ones in the one place. Yeah, I know, very specific. Can I go in here? May help you to go one color at a time, management. One color at a time, what? It's a big metal box with lots of machinery inside. This one has a robot in it. Beep boop. This is a printer room where machine parts are made. Also robots. Figured. It can also help to write down previous attempts. Management. Previous attempts of what? If all else fails, wait for the puzzle to reset. Maybe you'll get an easier one next time. Wait, what puzzle? Oh, this just leads me back out. So is there a door up here I could go into? There is. Oh, hey, a scientist. The luminescence index of liquid red phosphor decreased by a factor of 3.57% this last week. Alarmingly, to say the least, that's the sharpest decline I've seen, and the number is only increasing. We'll have to further concentrate the phosphor now, for it may be of any use. It's hard to believe, but there is a good chance this city could run out of light in as little as 6 months. What are we going to do? That is a question for the scientist, which is you, not me. A bunch of words are on the screen. I don't understand any of it. So is that it all in this area? Can I use... my jar and get some of that. Still don't know why I have this. I mean, it's not a very large item, but... Halt! Please await further instruction on security test. Please speak to the door robot. In order to gain further access to the labs, you must pass the security system test. Uh-huh. You must change the color of the lights into a specific configuration. Allow me. Wait, what was the hints? It was... what? It was... May help you to go one color at a time. Can also help to write down previous attempts. Management. All fails, which maybe we'll get an easier one. I don't want to write down, though. How am I supposed to know what colors they are supposed to go in? Maybe green, and I gotta make this one purple, because that was the only green one. Your light's correct. Nine tries left. Okay. Okay, I get it now. Two lights correct. So, actually, I shouldn't have done that. Three lights correct. Three lights correct. Four lights correct. Five lights correct. Access granted. Sweet! Reopen the lock. Awesome. Sweetness. That was actually a lot easier than I expected, but... Oh, no. My robot! What happened? I don't know, I left for a minute and... Please do not... Please do not approach. Well, what do you think about my robot voice? Was it pretty spot on? I cannot stop spinning. These robots are malfunctioning at a frightening rate. Physical damage from square particle anomalies is almost impossible to revert. No living person can touch them unless they have a death wish. But if we're lucky, sometimes the squares go away on their own. Not before taking away one of the robot's arms or legs. Or head. Okay. See, like, why do you have a head? Like, an awkward, different head than normal people. This is so tedious. I miss the good old days before our robot repairing robots broke down. All the robots have to be assembled by actual people. But aren't you a robot? No. I mean, do I sound like a robot to you? Not really. But your head is a TV? What does that have to do with anything? Never mind. Yeah, so they're not robots. Unless they're tamed and they just don't consider themselves to be robots. So, I mean... What are you then? So, are you just regular people? And... Like, what separates you, you as regular people, from you as regular people? Was it like some extended race to very, sorry, all of you, this one is inactive. Like, is it an extended race? Like, we have, you know, there's Asians, there's blacks, there's whites, and all that. But, like, does that mean you're like... Like, no, because they're all different heads, and it all relates to their occupation. Oh, it's weird. Don't understand it. I can barely keep my eyes open, man. How does Dr. Silverpoint get all this that energy? Dr. Silverpoint, I remember seeing Silver in the letter to the one tamed robot in the first place. I wonder what the author would do in this situation. Dr. Silverpoint usually references his work. Who's the author? I bet you the author's the guy in the computers. None of us have been sleeping very well in light of recent events. The square particles took out few of my robots last weekend. She fell asleep. Alright, let's go this way first. Baron's engineer just reported another sighting of particle in the cliff area. Well, nothing unusual at this point. Picking up some disruptions in Sector B of the city. This is consistent with our earlier findings. Not good at all. Oh, those square particles just took out two of my robots in the glen. Might have to put off the water analysis project for now. Monitoring. Alright, this leads me back out. Hi, Columba. Did I already go in here? Yes, I did. Okay. Hello? Oh, shoot. Hey, it looks like the one lady from the first area. If I had known you would be here so soon, I would have turned off the darned lock. Hello there. Sorry about the weird security measures. It's okay. They'll help me solve it. Did they now? So, can I help you with anything? Yeah. Do you know how I can get a library card? A library card? I'll have to ask the librarian for that. I tried. I needed to see the head librarian, but I can't get to see her without a library card. But at the same time, she's the one who gives out library cards. Really? Sounds like George, alright. I'm sorry you caught her on a bad day. Oh. Wait, I know. I could just give you my library card. Won't be hard for me to get another one. Oh, wow, thanks. There you are. You're all set, I think. Wait. Shoot. I forgot. The front desk library bots have facial recognition. And my photo on the card won't match you. Unless I tape a photo of my face on your face. That was a joke. Who knows, maybe it'll get lucky and the robot will take it away. Take it anyway. Worst comes to worst, you can always find somewhere to take a photo. I know that somewhere. What is this, though? Something is probably out on the shelf. It's a tube of glitter glue. You can have that if you want. Never know when you need glitter things up, right? Oh, are you sure? Yeah, I have tons of those. Thank you. You look a lot like the lady in the first area. So, you've been walking all over the world, huh? Mm-hmm. Jeez, I can't imagine. Do you get really tired sometimes? Kinda. But I don't mind, it's actually really pretty. Huh, I'm glad you think so. Even with the sun girl on, our world is still a beautiful place. What did the world look like with the sun? You know, it's kind of embarrassing to admit how little of it I've actually seen. Oh, ironic, isn't it? Even though I'm the world's leading researcher, all I do is stay here and build robots. They're the ones exploring the world. I just write down data, crunch numbers, generate graphs. Right. I've been seeing robots everywhere. I just thought it was because the world was too dangerous for most people to explore. That's not far from the truth, actually. But I know someone who still does his research firsthand. Oh? Even after segments of land started to collapsing and access to more remote areas became difficult. I mean, he outright built a machine that could fly. Something we all thought was not physically possible. Oh, that's... I asked him about working with us, so he provides us with all sorts of insights from time to time. But for some reason, he really didn't want to build robots. Or more specifically, coding them. How come? Beats me. I mean, he's happy to work with robots. In fact, he even... it's been a while since we last talked. Must be busy with his books now, yeah. Let him hear... Hey, Dylan? Doesn't that lady look kind of familiar to you? Yeah, looks like the lady in the first area. Wonder if she's ready to blow up. You gave me the amber. Yep. I almost wanted to ask her about it. Should I? Yeah, do it. Overwork yourself, okay? The journey is just as important as your end goal. Cliche, but true. I wonder if I show it to her, will it trigger a reaction? Also, I have a lot of stuff. I just want to hold it. Oh, that's... Wow. How did you get this? This robot lady in the Barrens gave it to me. She looked kind of like you. I see. Supposed to be such a breakthrough, you know? I even based her on myself, so I'll know it works. Breakthrough. We wanted to build a robot that acts like a person. Thinks like a person. A robot that isn't bound by its own code. Oh. But it turns out you can't really build something like that. Too many contradictions in the code made her unstable. That was the only time I've ever seen a robot go rogue. Scariest day of my life, tell you what. Rogue? But... She seemed so nice when we talked. Even if she talked a little weird. She's been repaired for some time now. My friend was able to stabilize her violent state through his own means. A real miracle worker, that. After he was through, she ended up turning out just like how I wanted. The damage was already done. I gave up on her back then. We all did. I'm sure she realized that. Now she won't ever come back. She won't even answer my letters. Sorry. Sorry for rambling. You should hold on to that amber, okay? I will. Oh, that's kinda... So that must have been what the incident was about. Kinda sad. So now the question remains. How do I put these things in? Like, what order do I have to do them? Because I gotta take my picture, stick it to the card, and then go in. Still have this water pill, don't know what that does. Have glitter glue, don't know what that does. Have the empty bottle, the novelty shirt, the strange journal, the weird film, the feather, and the amber, and have no idea what any of that does. I mean, I'm assuming I have to hold on to the sun, but... Actually, yeah, I need to take picture for reasons. Well, I got good news and bad news. Good news is the photo center is right behind me. Bad news is that it doesn't work, right? Heh, you're catching on quick. After operations ended in the Barrens, this place got shut down. All the engineers lost their jobs and became street vendors. Maybe Dylan and I can figure it out from somewhere. That's good. It would certainly help out people with expired IDs, like me. Still don't know. It's over here. Oh, hey, it's Lantern Guy. Oh, was that his home that we saw earlier? Hey, isn't that... Oh, goodness gracious, did the Messiah and I... And literally God themselves just break into my house? Oh, is that your... You heard of me? Keeps happening. Sorry about breaking into your house. We didn't actually break anything, but... Dylan said I should take these plastic discs for some reason. Should we put them back? It's okay, keep them. Wouldn't have been able to fix that machine anyway. I used to take them off my hands, I guess. The lenses, that is. The scientist wanted me to use them to fix the camera in the photo booth, but... You can imagine how that went. I'm just glad I didn't break anything. Alright, what's up here? I haven't gone up here yet. Whoa. Hey, that was the little fox in the flash. Oh, Dylan, did you see that fox just now? I ran behind the tree. Yeah? Sorry if you are looking for me. I cannot talk to you. Not now. Can you promise me something? Huh. If you can find a way to return, please do. Or what do you mean by that? I'll apply. Okay. There's no one here. I have a theory. And that is... Because why would he ask? He's a fox, right? But he could speak. And he asked if you could find a way to return. Please do. That's what's going to happen to Nico if he doesn't, like, find a way. Is he going to turn into, like, an actual cat? And was that person, like, once a fox-type person? What are you doing? Yeah, this was my original purpose. Watching cats? Warmth. Oh. That's a nice purpose. Oh, you look tired. Do you wish to rest? Can't sleep now. Dylan and I have stuff to do. I see. Okay, fill you up. All right, I can refill this tube with water from here. Yes. And then I can put the pill in said water. It dissolves really fast. Wait, where did that go? Medicated water. The water pill dissolved in it. Can I give it to you? So you never have to drink again? Oh, no, water storage. Alright, well, now I have that. What do I do with it? Oh, wait, can I put it on the... Can I go back up? I can! Okay, sweet. I could go up and put this on the water. It said the plants will grow, so... All right, here we go. Come on, put it on that plant. Put it on that plant. Good thinking, Dylan. This water should really help the seed grow. sprout a tiny leaf. Aw, adorable. Good luck, little plant. When arranging lenses, make sure that the thin lens is positioned between the two curved ones. Okay, this is information now. Positions between the two curved ones. Can you tell me how to work the camera thing again? Yeah, certainly. The thick lens should be positioned to the left of both of the curved lens. Alright, now I just need to know which curved lens goes where. So, right now it's gotta go, wait, what lens had to go? The thick lens had to go there? There's suddenly the thick, okay, so thick lens has to go on the far left. The camera, yes, memories, thick and thin. And by that I mean the con, wait, hold on, wait, what was that? Camera, oh, joyous memories, we went through thick and thin. So, okay. Concave is in, okay, I got it. So I need concave to be here, the thick one to be here, the thin one to be here, and the convex to be here. Yep. Alright. Jeez. Aw. Ouch, my eyes. Yay. It's a photo of me. Are my eyes always this big? Yeah, you got some pretty big eyes there, Nico. Aw, not a cat. That's a nice touch. Alright, and then combine that to that. The card has my face on it. Oh, Nico's so adorable. Boy or girl, I don't care. He's just so cute. Yeah. Barcode. Exhibit facial recognition. Photo match. Successful. You're good to go. Have a nice day, Miss Kip. Maybe I should change the name. I should have changed the name. This also might be a longer episode just because I'm going to try and finish it all in this one, so. Small tree. Anything over here? Nope. Okay. Some of the trash spilled over onto the floor. It's full. Looks like an old phone. Excuse me. Hey. Who the heck do you think you are barging in here like that? Don't you care? I don't care if you're the Messiah. Manners are still a thing. I'm sorry? Well, are you just here to apologize? Yes. I mean, no. I mean, I need your help. I'm not sure what I need to do next. I think I need to go into the tower. Seriously, you haven't figured out that one yet? I don't know how to get in. Well, I don't know either. Shouldn't Dylan help you with that? All I know is that nobody from this world can get in there. Not beyond the tiny entrance room, anyway. If anything, there might be a book on how the Messiah of all people can get in. But I don't know. I don't got anything like that in my collection. Would like to, though. I see. Well, crap. I'm guessing the tower was the one place with the big axe, and assuming that. Book is poking out from the shelf. A fruitful visit to the great prophet today. She seemed high in spirit. She told me that she saw another glimpse of the Messiah's arrival, more vivid than ever before. The Messiah will wake up in a dark house, she said. The vision included lights from a window and the sound of footsteps on wood. Regrettably, she is unsure of the house's location. Ray Cheese was also present at the meeting. I ended up visiting his house later, and we swapped notes. He has been very vigilant on recording the prophet's day-to-day mussings, and his writing has been significantly more legible lately. His children were endearing as ever. The older child, Calamus, has expressed an interest in reading. I offered to teach him as I did his father. Ooh, interesting. Book is poking out from the shelf. Oh, this book is a sketchbook of some sorts. Wednesday, another still life of some objects on my desk. Still not very good, but Silver can recognize the objects at least. Thursday, various sketches practice. Book is poking out from the shelf. Hey, I think this book is actually about clovers. Although its pigmentation is primarily black, the leaves display incredible iridescence when exposed to sunlight. These curious plants are most resilient and can even thrive in the mechanical sand of the harsh climate of the barrens. In the glen, it can also grow directly on top of the moss layers without competing with the moss for resources. Radiocarbon dating of fossils suggests these plants may be the first life forms to colonize the world. Wait, what about this? What about Clover Symbol in the book? Hey, this other book has a clover on its spine. And the rest of these books, too. Are they all about clovers? What? Of course not. This is just how the Arthur Moxes work. Oh. Well, he has to keep up with his mysterious persona, I guess. He's never told me his name. Wait, so he wrote all these books? Yes, he did. Can you tell me about this book? Oh, I have this book. I think it's written in some sort of words I don't recognize. Oh, let me see. Oh, of course. Of course! Hmm? More work from George, fine. Hey, kid. Nico. Looks I'm gonna have to translate this for you. Might take a while. Alright. Ugh. Excuse me. I know the feel, kid. I haven't had a good night's sleep in weeks. Ugh. That's not good. You know what? I have a guest room in the attic down the hall. Go take a nap. Just looking at you getting tired is making me tired. Alright, sweet. Is there anything else in here? Oh, I want to read that book. Also, I don't know if I want to sleep in the bed down the hall. Book is pulled off of the shelf. Thankfully, Dr. Silverpoint's team was able to replicate our prototype. On the right is an updated sketch of some modifications to the external design. More importantly, we used radically different architecture for the microprocessor due to the limiting resources this time, but it still should be capable of delivering the late prophet's message. The team suggested that taming was a lost cause. Oh, that's sad. Blue phosphor, rounder look, redesigned audio, compatible with longer clothing. Yeah, I don't want to sleep in there. I want to go sleep by the other guy, the cool guy who just provides warmth and protection. Actually, do I want to? Will that turn me into a cat? I don't want to risk that, actually. I just thought about that. Let's go back to the library. I don't want Nico to wake up as a cat. Like, see that? That's... Alright, let's go sleep. I'm a little tired from walking. Is it alright if I take a nap? Aw, yeah. Dreamscape. And... open sesame. Aw, you ate all the waffles. Or pancakes. I always get the two confused. What are you looking at? What? No, don't wake up and let me see. Oh my god. You can't do that to me. It scares me. Hey, Dylan. I guess you saw my dream. Yeah. It was... Come on, let's go. Nico, if you need to talk, I'm here, but oh my god. Look on the ground. But she deeply believed in the multiverse theory. Regarding an alternate version, she likened the probability of rolling of the dice. Recently, I found that theory easier and easier to believe, but I could not describe it very well back then. Nevertheless, I wrote it to the best of my abilities. After all, it felt only right to honor her in this way. There are six. Which one did you encounter? Oh god, I... Bookworm. Alright, you done? There, finally. Your insulation is done. Oh, that was faster than I thought. Well, yeah. You've been asleep for hours. Oh. Anyway, looks like this journal was meant for Dylan. Oh? Here, read it yourself. Greetings, Dylan. If you can finally read this, that means you are near the tower. Tower is the domain of an elusive entity. This being it is connected to the world. For now, you can think of it as the spirit of the world. It has no physical form, but it can communicate through computers and other machinery. You know who I am talking about, of course. When you first arrived here with our savior, no doubt contacted you right away. Through its own means, that entity will guide you both of you to the tower. The entire room is at the tower's base. Not only do you need the sun there, but you also... also three pieces of the previous sun. Savior will not be able to do anything there, you, Dylan, on the other hand. Look at the pattern on the floor. Do as it says. The window will be gone, so you need to bring it back. Someone tore out the other pages. Did you do this? No. When you're on your own, kid, I'm not sure what window means here. Maybe Dylan will figure it out somehow. Right. By the way, what does it mean by three pieces of the previous sun? I only have this sun. You have to explain everything? Huh. It's just a fancy word for objects containing yellow phosphor. You know the stuff that glows yellow? Oh. I do have pieces of amber and a feather. They fit the description, right? Yeah, but you only have two of them. And they're super rare, so it's not like you're just gonna find something like that on the ground, right? Okay. Here, you can have this.
Aww.
Oh. Looks like kinda like you. What? Never seen dice before? No. I mean, yes. I mean, it's just... Never mind. So, yeah. Need anything else? I'm good, thank you. Off you go, then. Don't screw things up, okay? Oh god, I really hope that wasn't a vision. Alright, just do what the room says. Do what the room says. It had an X on it, so I'm guessing I'm gonna have to, Alright. Oh my god. Hey Dylan, do you remember where the cafe is? Yeah. Oh good. I'm asking because, well, I'm a little hungry. Actually, I'm really hungry. I haven't eaten anything since I got here, so it's okay that we go get some food before I enter the tower. I hope they have pancakes. Yeah, I'm down. Oh hey, you're back. Did you manage to fix the elevator?
Mm-hmm.
Dylan and I went to the surface already. And... Well, I remember there being a cafe here. Do you have pancakes?
We sure do.
Wait, I don't have any money. Yeah, I can help you with dishes or something?
No, it's on the house.
At least I can do for the savior, right? Here, why don't you take a seat? I'll go fry up some for you.
Pancakes?
Aw, these pancakes are so good. Thank you so much.
No problem.
You looked really hungry. Yeah, I thought this would be my last chance to eat something before I go into the tower.
Ah, gotcha.
So I guess these pancakes are your favorite food?
Mm-hmm.
Well, almost. My favorite food in the world are the special pancakes that my mama makes. She likes to pick hazelnuts and grind them up into the batter.
Oh wow, that sounds amazing.
They taste amazing. She always made them when I was feeling sad. Or lonely, or... Mama. I really miss her. Oh, don't cry, Nico! I just have a bad feeling all of a sudden. Am I even here to save the world? You've been saying how the sun won't fix anything. I don't even know why I'm here. I just want to see my mama again. Oh. There. It's gonna be okay. I'm sure you'll be able to save the world. You're a tough kid. You managed to get this far already, right?
Yeah, but...
And you'll get to go home afterwards, right?
Right.
Hey, want some more pancakes? It's okay. I'll be fine. So yeah, thanks for coming by.
Thanks for listening.
And for the pancakes.
No problem. Good luck.
Aww. Don't worry, Nico. I'll get you out of here. Okay, we got this. We got this. Alright, exit. Alright. Hold on, I'm gonna have to move you guys out of the way for a sec. Here we go. Oh god. Yuko, please be there when I open it back up. Oh god, where are we? Yuko, where's the sun? Is this the inside of the tower? It's a lot darker than I thought. Wait, where's the sun? That's what I'm asking, Nico. Would you put the sun? Dylan, do you know what happened to the sun? Dylan? It won't let me answer. Dylan? I can't answer! Nico! Come on, Dylan, say something. No, Nico, I'm still here. I'm still here, Nico. I'm still here. Oh god. Oh god, it does. I don't have any of the items. Can't fast travel. I already know the notes. I didn't mean to click that. For some reason, I think I. Yep. Nico! Computer. Oh, Nico. Hello? Congratulations, you are now inside the tower. You're talking to me now? Correct. But you were always talking to Dylan before. Where is... Dylan has already left. I'm not gone, no! I had to resort to contacting you directly. Wait, so Dylan is gone just like that? Correct. For good? Correct. No! And so have you, Nico. Yeah, you can rest now. Thing that's happened here is like a bad dream. When you wake up, you will be home. But what's wrong? Thought there'd be more to it, you know? Thought we were supposed to go to the top of the tower. That the tower there was supposed to be somewhere we need to put the sun in. Now I don't even have the sun anymore. It was just gone. This feels wrong. But you did good. You saved the world, Nico. Are you not happy? Yes, I am, but it's just... No, I refuse to accept that. I refuse. What happens if I close out again? I didn't leave you, Nico, I swear. Nico feels uneasy. Oh god, okay, never mind. I take it back. Go to the bed. Oh god. I never even got to say goodbye to Dylan. Oh god. Oh man. Wait, what's in the back? What's in the back? Hold on, hold on. Something in the back. This is not over, regardless of what the entity told you. There is more to the story. Documents, my games, one shot. Look for this symbol. Once it's active, please relaunch the game. See you soon. Alright. Oh, okay. Alright. Hold on. I'm gonna put you guys in full screen. Hold on. Alright. So, documents. Hold on. Documents, my game is one shot. Okay, hold on. Documents. My games. Where's my games? My games. One shot. The author symbol. So author isn't the entity. Look for the symbol. Once it's active, please relaunch the game. How do I... Should I force stop? Okay. So it's active now. Okay. Hold on. Beep.
Nico. Yes.
Oh, Dylan? Yes. Is that you just now? I thought I heard your voice in my dream. Yes, it's me, Nico. It's me. It's me. I guess you're still not there. Wait, there's something in my pocket. I don't remember putting it there. Clover, yes. It was glowing. Why is it pulsing? Hold on. You're still here. Nico, why are you still here? You. Why did you come back, Dylan? I told you to stay away. You knew I tried to cut the story short. Is that it? You want more out of me. Is that it? Fine. If you don't want to leave, I'll make sure you never do. Oh god. Oh god, and the clover's gone. Wait. What? Back then, I told you about the entity as... Hold on. You guys see that too, right? Hold on, I'm gonna just make this full screen. That way you guys could kind of see all of this. So this was where the black clover was. Hold on, wait, why did that go away? And then see, it fits perfectly there. Back then I told you about the entity as little as possible. Apologies for what I did not want to put the librarian in danger. Alright, so up. Wait, right. Yeah, up, okay. This has been a habit of silencing the people who learn of its true nature. This being has a habit of silencing people that learn its true nature. Regrettably, I have seen it happen to a dear friends. Wait, what was it? Yeah, okay, this way. I just gotta double check. I don't wanna mess this up. Do not worry. The entity cannot touch you. Wait, what was it? I keep reading it before I looking at... Wait, which way do I go? Wait, which way? Do I go back? Nor can it do anything to me. I already left the world on my own terms. I never meant for the entity to exist. But now that it is fully sentient, one thing became clear. You said this one, right? Yeah. The entity seeks death. Death to itself, death to the world, a relentless desire that manifested physically. You said this one. I don't want to mess this up. You've already seen the scars. So the far one. All
Right now, the entity is doing everything it can to impede your progress, stalling it for even a few minutes. Before you inevitably bring the sun to the tower's summit. That is where you, God, will make the final judgment of the world. Oh, God. Ha! Oh, me! Okay, but in all seriousness, I'm kind of freaking out right now. Of course, the entity will contact you again there. Oh, God, no, not that one. And when it does, it will trick you into shattering the sun. This will end the world instantly. Nothing but silence. More silence. No, no, it's not that simple. I'm sorry, I do not know what to do in a situation like this. But I think I have to tell you the truth. The sun is the Messiah's tie to the world. Oh my God! Oh, wait, hold on, I got it now. Oh, so does that mean I have to either... As long as the sun is intact, the Messiah remains trapped here. Oh my God. Hold on, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Does that mean I have to choose between either Nico or the world? Wait, what didn't I do? Was that what has to be empty? It's probably what has to be empty, huh? Crap. Oh my God, So it's either save Nico or destroy the entire world. How am I... Wait, shoot, did I mess that up? Oh my God. Sharing the sun may terminate this world, but... is also the only way for the Messiah to return home. Oh my god. Sorry if I'm not talking a lot. I'm trying to just think what I'm gonna do. Oh my god, that's such... I don't want to, like... Because Nico... I cannot lose Nico. But at the same time, that means death to an entire world. An entire world. I don't think it's just talking about, like, the one planet or whatever. Like, that, I'm thinking it's, like, the entire universe. Well, of this, yeah, this entire universe. I did not realize things could end up like this. Please forgive me. Oh my god. Alright, hold on. I'm gonna put you guys back in the regular window. Right. Oh my god. It's the light bulb. Thank goodness it's safe. I guess Dylan isn't coming back. Nico, I'm here. Dylan? Yes? Is that really you? Thought you were gone. I never left you. Aww. Oh, I was feeling a bit scared back then. Thought you- I was completely alone. That was silly of me to assume, wasn't it? I guess we need to figure out where to go now and... The sun. It lit up on its own. Oh my god. Okay. Alright, so real talk here. Either... So, let's say I save Nico, okay? Nico survives. Nico survives, but then all the people that were counting on me and Nico end up dead and betrayed. And that means the robot who wanted a second chance, all the regular robots that haven't been tamed, can't get tamed, and will die. The kids in the village and all the villagers that had help for me. And all the people in the city. That includes, like, the guy that was there. And the two kids that were there. In the glen. Oh, God. I don't know if I could kill Mrs. Fahrenheit. But then if I don't. If I don't get Nico back home and I do save the light, yeah, everyone gets to live. But Nico, the character who was counting on me, he himself was counting on me from the very beginning. He's looked for me to for guidance and all that, and to just help him get back home so he could see his mom again. And he's just a little kid. And if I don't get him there, he's gonna be trapped here forever alone. But replacing the sun, okay, this is what I'm thinking, because throughout the entire story, there have been people saying that the sun is not going to fix anything. Like, the sun was just the tipping point. Like, there was countless other things that led up to this point. And the sun is just kind of like the symbol. I mean, yes, granted, it's going to collapse no matter what. If I crush it and everyone's going to die, but even if I save the sun, that doesn't guarantee them safety and, like, prosperity, is what I'm trying to say. Oh my god.
So earlier in the series, I was like, I have the most conflicted feelings about this, but this is actually tearing me apart. Guess I should pick it up, right, Dylan? And then we're back at the beginning. Let's just see where this goes right now. The house is all fine now. Wait, hold on. Sink. There's nothing in the fridge. There's wood neatly stacked in the fireplace. So you actually made it here. I guess you win, Dylan. I'll tell you how to save the world then. When you reach the summit, shatter the light bulb end. Oh, wait, I'm gonna go back down. Can I get more story or no? No. Oh my god, and it's giving me back memories of like the very beginning of the game. I wonder where that eater is coming from. I'm just humoring you. I know you've been getting help from a certain someone. He already told you about the choice, didn't he? Are you still planning to save the world, Dylan? Why are you trying so hard for this? Have you even figured out what this world is? I told you at the beginning, your mission is to help Nico leave. Because Nico isn't part of this world. Nico is the only thing worth saving here. The final choice is up to you. I can't go against my programming. You only have one shot, Dylan. Oh my god! I didn't even expect the ending to be this good. I was like, oh, it's probably going to be a decent ending. It's probably going to be one. I mean, I'm not maybe going to remember. It's probably going to be more about the journey than the end. But oh my god. You only have one shot, Dylan. If you choose to smash the light bulb, then Nico wakes up back home like it was all a dream. If you let Nico return the sun, the child will have to bear the weight of his sacrifice. At least tell Nico the truth. You do care about Nico, don't you? Sure is taking a while. Guess this elevator leads to the top of the tower, Dylan. Are you excited, Dylan? Finally gonna save the world. No, it's for real this time, because you're here. And then, I'll get to go home for real this time, too. Can't wait to see everyone again. Are you okay, Dylan? You seem a little quiet. Nico? Yeah? I need to tell you something. I'm listening. Can't save both. The world and you. What? What's that supposed to mean, Dylan? To send you home, we must break the light bulb. What? But won't that end the world? Yeah. I don't want that to happen. Neither do I, Nico. So what happens when we save the world? What happens to me? I don't know. You don't? Oh my god. So this is where the sun belongs. If I put the sun here, we'll be able to save the world, right? If I want to go home, I have to break it. Oh. Dylan, what should I do? What's the right thing to do? Oh my god, Nico, don't look at me with those eyes. Oh my god, I'm actually tearing right now. This is... Oh my god, I... Return the sun or return home. This is the... Oh my god. How can I make this choice? Oh my god. Alright, hold on. I'll be right back. I gotta get a drink of water. I honestly don't know what to do. Oh my god. And like, I don't have anyone I can ask right now. No, I'm just home alone. And I can't ask you guys, because this is going up. Like, I've already made the choice by the time you guys seen this, so... Oh my god. I can't do it to him. He's just a kid. He's just a kid. I can't. I couldn't give that, like, I couldn't have a child bear that pressure throughout the rest of his life. If he goes home, at the end of the day, he'll be happy. He'll get to see his mom again, he'll get to grow up, he'll get to live his life the way he wanted to live it. And if I have him stay here, he's going to be trapped forever, never see his friends or family or neighbors ever again. And sure, you could argue that he made friends and family here through the robot and the lantern guy and the kids in the ruins. I think what's really splitting me right now is the kids in the ruins, because they're just as old as Nico, if not younger. And the hardest part, and I don't know if it means that the world will completely disappear. Like, I will be sending them to the void, which is like, you know, everyone's greatest fear about death is the void. Like, if there's absolutely nothing. Or I don't know if I'm just, like, killing them, and if they have an afterlife to go to. Because without bringing up a lot of religion or anything, I do believe that there is an afterlife, but... Oh, God. I don't think I could... My conscience won't allow me to doom a kid from living the life he wants to live. Like, that would just... I couldn't do that. And even if I do put the sun there... It's not guaranteeing the safety of the world, so it might crumble apart anyways. And even though Nico's first mission was, you know, daylight savings time, I just couldn't. I can't doom Nico to that. I trust your judgment, Dylan. Dylan? What happened? It's very dark in here. Oh.
Because you're right at the end of this passage. I think you hear a voice too. Mama? I could hear her calling me. All I need to do is pass through this wall. Finally be home again. Dylan, I guess? I guess this is goodbye. I'm glad I got to meet you, Dylan. Thank you for everything. Oh, Nico, don't cry. I'm gonna cry. Oh, and he just walks off the screen. He just walked flat out off the screen. Like, it's not like he disappeared once he reached the border. He walked off the desktop. Like, he went onto the wallpaper, went onto my little favorites bar, and then off the screen. Oh my god. Oh, now I gotta see my repercussions lay down in front of me. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm actually crying right now. I don't think I've ever cried for a game before. Oh, I don't even know if that was the right choice in the end. I just love Nico too much. Oh my god, and the Glen is gone, and... Oh my god, Night Margin, that was the most beautiful game I think I've ever played. Oh my god, that easily makes number one on my list of favorite games. Oh. And I was not expecting that ending to be as good as it was, like, holy shit. I expected, you know, some goodbyes, he'd put in the light bulb, he'd be sent home, and we'd all live happily ever after kind of thing. I was not expecting that. Oh my god, that is the most well-crafted game I think I've ever played. And then it ends on that. Fatal error, savior not found, shutting down. Oh my god, that was a... That hit a little harder than I expected it to. Oh. That was honestly the best game I've ever played. The fourth wall breaks were beautiful. Like, they were perfect fourth wall breaks. I wish more games that did break the fourth wall would break them to a much larger extent like this game. Character development was amazing. The character to player connections were unbelievable. Oh, the world you set up was amazing. The story, the writing, everything about that. The music was great. Oh, that was such a good game. That was such a good game. I don't know. I don't think I'll go back and play it again. Like, I could easily just go through it, because now that I know all the puzzles and everything, and I can see what the other ending was. But I don't think I want to. I think that'd ruin the experience for me. And even so, it'd be more of a reason for you guys to go and play it yourself. That was honestly the best game I've ever played. Anyway, that's enough of me talking. I'm not even sure what to play after this, honestly. I did get a few recommendations earlier on another video that I might look into again some more. But if you guys have any other recommendations on other good games I should play, go ahead and leave a comment below. But oh my god, that was just... That was... unbelievably great story. Oh, anyway, I've been talking long enough. This video's been long enough. Thank you all so much for watching. My name's ToasterCat. Stay awesome.